Ford, a traditional gold replica of his number 12 Ford. I think you can clear space for a gold car, right? It is pretty prominent, so make sure that gets up there on the shelf. In addition, Blaney's championship winning performance at Phoenix earned him the Sunoco Diamond Performance Award, given every year to the NASCAR Cup Series champion.
And now, the biggest award, the Bill France Cup. To officially present it, please welcome NASCAR President Steve Phelps.
Thank you, Tim. Before I bring up our guest of honor, okay. To bring our 2023 champion to the stage, we have a bit of a surprise. This rock band has been selling out venues all over the world. To introduce Ryan, please welcome some of his closest friends and one of his all-time favorite bands, Whiskey Myers.
Thank y'all for having us out. We couldn't be more proud of our good buddy. He's an amazing driver and even a better human being.
And clearly, he's got great taste in music. Ryan, we're proud of you, Pod. We're honored to be asked to do this. So with all that being said, please welcome the 2023 NASCAR Cup Series champion, Mr. Ryan Blaney.
Screw this up one way or another. So
thanks for everyone for being here. I really appreciate it. Congratulations to Ben and Cole, the Thorsons, Gene Haas on your championships. Thank you guys for being here tonight. So hope everyone had a great Thanksgiving. I'll try to keep this fairly short because I know I'm excited to get out on the town just as much as you guys. So we'll get it going. So just amazing year. Congratulations to all the teams, drivers, owners, sponsors. On a 2023 season, I mean, it flies by really quick, but you know, it's a big grind, like everyone says, and it takes a lot of people to put it all together. So I know we're all competitors and we don't agree on the track a lot of times, but it is a true honor to race with the best in the world on a weekly basis, and I do appreciate that. It's incredible. I look back on 10 years when I walked in to meet RP and Tim Cindric in 2012, and
Ryan Blaney.
I have to give thanks to, and There's so many people that are involved that gives you opportunities.
2023 NASCAR Cup Series your champion. Up, Chase Elliott, 2020 NASCAR Cup Series champion.
Jump right into that. So first of all, I want to thank
2023 NASCAR Cup Series champion.
They're
Elliott and Blaney.
All right.
Two best NASCAR Cup champs.
Dad race. That's just what I wanted to do, and I wanted to be like my dad, and super lucky to be able to see it at a young age, and kind of just get the whole spectrum, of seeing what it was like as a driver, or seeing how teams operated. Kevin, I was going to get to you later, but congratulations on a great career. But, it's kind of freaking me out because, I remember when I was Keelan's age with my dad at driver intros and I was meeting all you guys. And now it's made me feel really old. And seeing Keelan at driver intros and him racing now, it's kind of reminds me of when I was his age. But, obviously my mom is a huge MVP. She might take the mantle for that because I think everyone in here knows, I think mothers sacrificed the most for young kids doing their sports growing up, making sure that you're where you need to be on time. I have two amazing sisters, Emma and Aaron. They're happy to be here tonight. I'm happy to have them and my biggest supporters growing up and sort of this very day. My beautiful girlfriend, Gianna. It's been an amazing ride, huh? It's wild that we're here right now and looking forward to many years to come. So I love you very much. I really wish my grandpa could be here to see this and share it with my dad. So thank you. Tommy Baldwin. Tommy was an amazing guy. And, so Tommy gave me my first start in 2012 when Dad was running cup cars for him on the Xfinity side. And that opened up a ton of doors. I'm hoping Tommy is doing the best he can right now and hope to talk to him very soon. But driving for Tommy, that led me to get talking to Brad Keselowski in 2012 after an Xfinity race at Kentucky, I believe it was, and opened the door for me to drive trucks for him, opened the door for, the Penske deal, in Xfinity, and just amazing that I got an opportunity at that time, and I will always be thankful for Brad for doing that, and Wayne Setterington, Jeremy Thompson at BKR, amazing people that worked at that race shop, and that was such a great truck team. The Wood Brothers, Eddie, Len, Leonard, Glenn, driving for you all from 2015, 2017 was an absolute dream. I grew up loving your family, your team, and to be able to drive for you guys for a few years was an absolute dream come true. To get my first win with you guys at Pocono was unbelievable, and to be a small portion of the wins that you've had, to get you your 99th win, just to be a small portion of that is always so special, and to be part of your family, even though I'm not driving for you anymore, is always special. And Eddie gave me a coin. They do the challenge coins every year, so Eddie gave me a coin before the race, and I think it was good luck. It was Glenn's coin, and I definitely think it brought us luck during that race. So looking forward to you guys getting number 100. So Roger and Kathy Penske, thank you guys. It's like you said earlier, it's hard to believe it's been over 10 years since we first met, and nothing more as a kid I wanted to do than to win you a championship and just be successful, because I was such a big fan of you, not only in NASCAR but in every form of motorsport, and just had such a huge respect for you and what you did, and that you've stuck with me for over 10 years has been unbelievable, and I'll always be thankful for that. So to be able to do things, to accomplish things that you haven't accomplished yet, to be a part of that, winning the 600 and the 500 the same year, winning back-to-back championships, to be a part of that is just so special. And amazing people that I have to thank too. Greg Penske, Walt Zarnicki, Tim Sindrick, Bud Danker, Mike Nelson, Jonathan Gibson, Travis Geisler. I mean, all those folks have given me such great opportunities and have stuck with me for so many years. I'll never be able to thank them enough. And I guess this is the best way to thank them. So I guess I'll get into our partners now, right? John Menard. John Menard is here. John has been an amazing person. The Mahold Menard family. We've been together since 2018, and it's been a fun ride. For all you've done in motorsports and your amazing life, it's a pleasure to be able to be partnered with you, and to bring you the ultimate sports pinnacle is amazing, and look forward to the years to come. So thank you and your family. Ford Performance, Ford Motor Company, you guys are unbelievable. It's been a pleasure to be with you for over 10 years with the Blue Oval family. Congrats on 2-2, 2-for-2 with the next gen with Joey and myself, and super congrats on sweeping the weekend, and look forward to the Dark Horse Mustang next year. Rush H Engines, Doug Yates, you have the impossible job of trying to get bottom end and top end when drivers complain about wanting both. And I think every engine manufacturer will agree with me. You have an unattainable goal, but you stick with us, and I really appreciate it. And congratulations to you. Body Armor, Advanced Auto Parts, Dex Imaging, Worth, Tom O'Neill is here tonight, so thank you for being here, the Worth family. Discount Tire, won my first race with them in 2013 with Team Penske, so that's a lot of fun to do it again 10 years later at Martinsville. Wabash, Dent Wizard, just amazing partners. So where's my 12 group at? Where are my guys at? Over there? Make noise there and back there? You guys are rock stars, man. You guys are unbelievable. It's been so much fun to work with you guys, you know, the last handful of years. It's been fantastic, and you guys deserve it just as much as me. Jonathan, second year together. It's been a fun ride so far. We've been awesome to win some races together. I remember when we sat down and had a beer at King Canary and tried to figure out what we were going to do. And it's cool that what we've done. So good job. It's amazing, man. Daniel Lynch, my interior guy, I did want to shout you out last year on the road. Congrats. Looking forward to your next chapter. Hopefully you can relax a little bit, probably a little bit more beer drinking time on the weekends. I wanted to talk about our summer struggles. Jonathan talked about it a little bit beforehand that we started off the year fairly decent and won the 600. And then we had two or three really bad months. And it was really, really easy to throw in the towel, call it quits for everyone on this group, everyone at Team Penske who were struggling. But they didn't do that. They dug down and they figured out what we needed to do to be better. And that's a group that I'm super proud to be with. Those are the people you want to surround yourself with. Is people who don't
best friends,
complain and just get down and you know, they just put the work in. And we have amazing men and women who do that. Over 400 employees at Penske, 72,000 worldwide. They did the work and they did get down. They just figured out the problem and came up with a solution. So this is as much your championship as it is mine. I took a couple really hard hits this year. So I appreciate AMR and UPMC, Dr. Mickey Collins and the NASCAR medical staff for helping me out. You guys really helped me out. It was a lot worse than what I seemed, and you guys really did an amazing job. So thank you. Also NASCAR officials, all the NASCAR personnel, Lisa, Ben, Jim, unbelievable. Mike Helton, it's amazing to share this with you. So thank you for what we do. Looking forward to many years to come. Thank you to fans. And one thing I want to close out with, sorry, I've been going a long time, but so my dad told me a neat story about when we started the playoffs. My dad, if you guys who know my dad, he's a very reserved guy. He doesn't talk very much. And, he was kind of I started saying I wanted to be like my dad growing up. And as a kid, I think you just want to make your parents proud. And so when he started kind of being my motivational speaker, like through the playoffs, like he was telling me the story about the path. He sees the path to the championship. And, he was visualizing this path that we could go on this run and make this championship run. And the first few races, I was like, it's dad saying dad stuff, you know. But as we kind of went on, I started believing it more and more. And, we won Talladega. He said, the path's getting bigger. We won Martinsville. He said, the path lit up. And I guess we got through the gate at Phoenix. So just unbelievable. Dad's motivation, his talk, his help is super cool. He visualized it. And took me a while to believe it, but fortunately we all did, and it's here now. So sorry for the long speech. I kind of lost track of time, but thank you guys for being here. Enjoy your Christmas. We'll look forward to seeing you guys in LA in 24. We do have a toast that we do at Team Penske to close off the night. Something kind of a tradition whenever we win races over there. So to us and those like us, cheers. Have a good night.
Oh yeah.